This is Srinivas Lakyam. Today we are going to discuss Spark demo. Do you know what is Spark? Spark is a big data processing engine. Big data processing engine. Before Spark, we have MapReduce, right? We have already MapReduce. It is also a big data processing, right? So we have already existed technology MapReduce to process big data. Why do we require Spark again? Okay, let me discuss. So Hadoop has two components. One is HDFS. HDFS is for storing data, and MapReduce is for processing. MapReduce is for processing. So here MapReduce has two phases: mapper phase and reducer phase. Mapper phase and reducer phase, we have two phases in MapReduce. So here MapReduce, when you give any input to MapReduce application, first that input goes to mapper process your input. Assume your file has multiple blocks. All blocks are presented in different nodes in your Hadoop cluster. Okay, so mapper process your blocks and stores intermediate results in disk and passes that input to reducer. Reducer reads this intermediate results and processes it, and finally stores in where? Hadoop cluster, in HDFS. So here MapReduce uses both memory and disk for processing your data, but Spark uses only in-memory computing. So compared to MapReduce, Spark process very faster. Okay, Spark is 100 times faster than MapReduce in memory processing. Spark is 10 times faster than MapReduce in disk processing. MapReduce is 10 times faster than MapReduce in disk processing. Okay, and one more important difference is MapReduce process only HDFS file system. It process only HDFS file system. It means MapReduce tightly coupled with HDFS. But Spark can process HDFS file system. It can process local file system. It can process NoSQL data. It can process RDBMS data. It can process AWS data, it can process any storage data. It can process any storage data. It means Spark is not tightly coupled with HDFS. So without HDFS also we can run Spark. It can process any storage system data. Okay, it can process any storage system data. And one more main difference, if you see, Hadoop has two components, right? What are they? First one, HDFS, and second one, MapReduce, right? So HDFS is to store data, and MapReduce purpose is to process data, right? So here we write MapReduce algorithms in by using Java API or by using Python API, and it also supports many languages. It supports what? It supports many languages. Right? But recommended is which one? Java. Recommended is Java. Why it is recommended Java? Hadoop is implemented in Java. That's why it is recommended is Java. You can write MapReduce programs in Java. Okay. Spark is implemented in Scala language. And you can write Spark applications. We can write Spark applications. In Scala, and you can write in Java. You can write in Python. And you can write in R language. It supports currently, it supports Scala, Java, Python, and R API. So we can get Scala, Java, Python, R API. So if you are strong in Java, you can implement Spark applications in Java. If you are strong in Python, you can implement Spark application in Python. If you are strong in R, you can implement in R language. If you want to implement this Spark application in Scala, you can implement in Scala. It is highly recommended to write Spark applications in Scala, because if you write Scala application either in Java, Python, R, again these are converted into Scala language only. Here also, if you write MapReduce applications in any other language, again it is converted into Java. So if you write Java, if you write MapReduce applications in using Java, it is lengthy coding. But Scala is, compared to Java, Scala is less code. Scala is a functional oriented language, and it is object oriented language. It supports both features, functional and object oriented language. Object-oriented programming language. It supports both features. Okay. See, in Hadoop, instead of MapReduce, we have frameworks, right? In Hadoop, instead of MapReduce, we have Pig, we have Hive. These frameworks reduces length of the code and improves development time. It means it reduces what? Development time. So if you use MapReduce, we write code in where? Java language. Java means it will take time to implement your code because your code length is high. So to reduce that one, we have different frameworks in Hadoop called Pig and Hive. These are also processing frameworks. If you use Pig, Pig has its own language called Pig Latin. Pig Latin. And Hive has its own language called SQL, High Query Language. High Query Language. High Query Language. These are similar to SQL. These are similar to SQL. Structured Query Language. If you have a knowledge on structured query language, you can easily write SQL queries and Pig Latin queries. SQL queries are very simple and smaller. So it reduces what? Development time. So for example, if you want to implement MapReduce to solve one problem, assume it may take around 50 to 60 lines of code. The same thing we can implement in Pig or Hive within 2 to 4 lines. So it reduces what? Length of the code. So Hive and Pig has simple queries. Okay. And one more important point is, if you write either Pig script or either SQL query, again these are internally converted into MapReduce applications. High level we write Pig or Hive queries, but internally these are converted into where? MapReduce programs. Okay. Same as Pig and Hive, Spark SQL, Spark Core, and Spark SQL. So by using Spark SQL, we can use SQL syntaxes. So we can write SQL queries. So in a Spark environment, we can write SQL queries. Instead of writing lengthy code by using Spark Core API, you can use simple Spark SQL queries. So these are like SQL queries. Okay. So like Hive SQL, Pig Latin, we have what? Spark SQL. In Spark SQL, we can use SQL kind of syntaxes. Okay. Assume I written map Hadoop application by using MapReduce, and by using I written some part by using Pig, I used some part by using Hive SQL. Can we combine all these in single application? Can we combine all these MapReduce, Pig, Hive in single application? Can I call Pig scripts in MapReduce? Can I call Hive queries in MapReduce? We cannot, right? We cannot call Pig scripts in MapReduce. We cannot call Hive queries in MapReduce. We cannot call Hive queries in Pig script. We cannot call Pig scripts in Hive queries, right? But Spark has four components, right? Five components. One is Spark Core. We write core programming by using Spark Core and Spark SQL and Spark Streaming and Spark Mlib and Spark graphics, Spark graphics. We have 5 components in Spark. Assume I'll get the data, streaming data. Assume I get streaming data. I can read that streaming data by using Spark streaming, Spark streaming, and in the same application I can use Spark SQL to process that streaming data. We can convert this streaming data into Spark tables or data frames. So here between this I used Spark Core. Spark Core. So I load this streaming data into Spark Core API and I can transform that data. Then finally I convert that transformed data into Spark data frame or data set or Spark table by using Spark SQL API. It means we can write interoperable application. In a single application I can combine these 5 APIs. It is not possible with Hadoop. You can write MapReduce individually, we can write PigScripts individually, we can write HiveSQL individually, we can write Flume application, streaming application separately. We cannot combine all these in single application to meet one particular requirement. But we can combine what? All these APIs in a single application. Okay, this is the main greatest advantage of Spark. By using Spark, we can write what? Interoperable application. It means I am getting continuous flow of data into my application. So I read that continuous data by using Spark streaming. Once I got data, I stored that data into RDD by using Spark Core API. On that data, I can apply some transformations. And I store that data, convert that transformed data again into table or data frame or data set. And I can process it. Finally, I can store that data into any storage location. Okay? So by using Hadoop, Hadoop can process what? Hadoop means MapReduce or Pig. MapReduce or Pig or Hive can process only HDFS file system. But Spark can process any storage data. After MapReduce process HDFS file system, again it stores result back into where? In HDFS only. But in Spark, we can read data from one storage, we can process it, we can store in any data storage. Okay? These are different advantages of Spark. Okay? Thank you.